Hey there, Super Spaz here, and welcome back. Maybe that might be one of the last times you hear me say that, at least for this series. I don't know. Based on last episode's near squad wipe, it's entirely possible. With us today, we have Snow Leopard Paddon, Kyle Budwine, Cyclops Budwine, Chancellor Krebz, Derek Demon Vernon, Shadow Fox, Anna Shadow Fox Vasquez, David Spike Rice, Craig PlayStation Vita Kearns, and Adonis Fast and Furious Smith. Yeah, honestly, our big goal here is to capture a Muton, I believe. I'm gonna double check it one last time. I'm pretty sure that's the one, though, that gets me the tactical corporal. Everything else is just kind of like, yeah, whatever. Not really much going on there, except maybe the scientists. If I can get a sectoid captive, I'll try. Really, I need to get an outsider captive, just one, so I can start hitting back. A lot of people, well, just one person I noticed said, I pray this turns around when I get mechs. Well, it's gonna be quite a few missions before I even field them. And to be honest, a tier 1 mech suit isn't really gonna hold its own. Like, I'm gonna have to be really clever if I wanna use it, so I don't know. It's pretty crazy, though. It's amazing. Amazing how far behind this campaign got, too. It's 11th of October in the campaign. I used to actually keep, like, at least a little less than a month behind at the very beginning, and then I just slowed down. Now it's, like, January, and I'm still in October in the campaign. And I have a theory as to why I've been doing worse, and it's not just because, oh, I want to play XCOM 2,
for this mission will be in India,
and I'm tired of this game. It's not that. It's actually probably because I haven't been playing as much. If you've noticed, my uploads have been few and far between, and it's because I haven't been able to play XCOM so much as I used to. So I think, you know, use it or lose it, and I've kind of lost it. Is this that map? Is this that map? Is that the Brothers in Arms map? It is. I think it is. This is the map where Beagle Rush, you know, if you know him, I don't know if you do, you might not have ever heard of him. But he's pretty big. It's a pretty big deal. I think this is the map where he had his tragic squad wipe. I think I recognize it. Yeah. Because he tried to retreat to here. He could have made it. Because the exit's, like, right up there. Oh, no, it's not. It's, like, up here. But he missed it. He missed the exit. Or something crazy like that. Point is, I'm going to be taking this mission very, very slow. I don't want to die. I don't want to lose because of some stupid technicality or some... Well, not technical. Obviously, I'd lose because I'm an idiot and I suck at this game. But I don't want to lose for other reasons either,
Roger that.
To be honest. I want to lose because I gave it my all and it turns out this was too much for me. And I just want to prove that, you know, not everybody can handle Ironman Impossible. No, obviously not everybody can. It takes a special kind of someone to think they can even attempt to do it. I'm not sure. I guess I want to put Budwine up here. This would be a pretty good vantage point for him. So I'm going to do that, even though he's not steadied, but I'm going to do it anyway. Because I'm an idiot. I'm not a clever man. Oh, I just overwatched Vasquez. I wasn't supposed to do that. Oh well. Yeah, they're going to activate. But if we're lucky, they'll get caught at least by one of our overwatchers. That's a lot of thin men. Vasquez is snapshot too, so I'd probably have to move her and fire. But it looks like we... Oh. Oy vey, they spread out. That's never a good thing. In fact, well, I might go so far as to say it's bad. Yes, that is not ideal. For multiple reasons. But the first reason is because they seem to have split off in multiple directions. Some went that way, some went this way. Which means I'm kind of fighting a two-front battle here. Which is never what you want to do. Especially if they can just take cover and then start flanking you. In very... how shall I say, interesting positions. Yeah, like this I would deem unsafe because what if they take that tree right there and then flank me? I really can't scout out too far. Hell, I really do need to get some shots off with my sniper and I need to start blowing them up with rockets and I don't actually even have any offensive grenades. We still need a thin man captured too, I realize. So I guess our strongest first move would be to, you know, move somebody out or battle scan with somebody who has a battle scanner like Adonis Smith. Now, Smith's also gonna have to start throwing smoke grenades, but he doesn't have that perk that lets him... Oh, I didn't give you smoke grenades. That's fine, then. You can throw a battle scanner in full cover, and I don't have to fear for your existence, really. Probably here is all right. I hope. I hope it is. I don't know where I want to throw the scanner. If I go here, I might want to start, like, I want to take out one of the sides first. So I want to make sure. Well, then that's not a very good place to throw a scan, is it? Probably here, then. Probably here is where I want to throw the scan from if I'm going to start shooting that way. And then just take cover. Hi there. Hi, who can you see? Who's this? Okay. That's fine. Now, I suppose here would be all right. It would get me some much-needed information about these thin men. So let's do that. Oh, hi. Yeah, you stepped out. You can see that guy now. That's the guy who got overwatched. So we got three over there, and we know there's a pot of, what, like five? That's great. That's real good. All right. Wow, 97. Oh, shit. I should take that shot, shouldn't I? Yeah, can you just eliminate that guy, Budwine? That would be great. Please do. Great shot. Great shot, kid. That was one in a million. Now I need to start, like, cranking things up a notch. All right, what do you got for it? Ooh, you can suppress one. Oh, beautiful. Oh, you got actually some pretty good accuracy, to be honest. I guess I should suppress, then, because we're not... Yeah, no, I don't see any other ones, so over here at least, but I could be wrong. And I don't know if I'm going to hedge my bet on that, but I could send David Rice up. I don't want to put him here, because that's, you know, what if one of them is right there? Then we're in big trouble. I need a smoke for sure, everybody. Everybody needs to get smoked right now.
Moving out.
Let's see what we got. I mean, I'm confident that, oh, Jesus, David Rice. All right, maybe you can finish him off, potentially. I mean, you can't suppress, so I don't see any reason why you would do that. Let's just try for it. Good work.
Taken care.
All right, now there's only one over there. So unless we want to start scouting out forward and then suppress that guy so he doesn't move. He might move. I don't know. He might be ballsy enough to do it. That's good. This is a good turn so far. We got two of the five. One of them's still over there, and we know some others ran over that way. But we don't know where, so that's a problem. And honestly, I don't want to run too far for... Oh, motion trackers. Of course I have one of those. I could always make use of that if I wished. If I wanted to know exactly where they all were.
Aye, aye.
Then I can even start moving people or covering them if it gets too hairy. Oh, let's try it. Oh, yeah, they're both up there. So if we suppress that guy and then we cover against these yahoos up front, I'm assuming they're, like, right behind this cover here, we should be okay. We should be somewhat all right, possibly. I don't know. I don't know what these thin men are going to do. I'm probably going to smoke forward on my rock. I'm going to put my rocketeer up here to handle them. Or at least try, or die trying. I don't want to spread everybody out too much, is my point. No, still can't see them. But I know they're somewhere over there. I could put her on Overwatch. That would be okay. I could put everybody on Overwatch up here. Craig Kearns, you should get into some kind of full cover and throw smoke, though. What's the best full cover for you to take right now? And then our assault, of course, could go even further forward and start taking names, but I don't know if I want to do that just yet. I might want to, you know, put a choker on the name list for now. All right. Actually, let's leave the suppression for last in case we do reveal some of the baddies. I doubt they'll give us too much trouble flanking because they're so far forward now. Hell, if I had to guess, I'd actually say they're, like, right... Because if that guy's there, they're, like, right back here. They are, like, right... Yeah, they're like, right back there. They're in that little crevasse, even, if you will. I mean, you don't have to. I won't make you, but I'm just saying. That's what some people might call it. Not me, no. No, sir. I'm strictly a crevice guy. But I'm going to say, since we can't see with Vasquez... Yeah, okay, so why don't you... Take a kind of mildly dangerous position over here. No, is that too dangerous? I don't know. I just need to get the smoke on those two. Can I do it from back here? I don't know. It's a question. I may just do it from here to be safe. Thin men do have a penchant for hitting things in full cover, though, so I'm not sure what the safest move is. And then perhaps we can move the assault somewhere else next to them, like on that rock, or hunker down, some such business, I don't know. We'll see what we can pull off. My hopes aren't terribly high. Alright, why don't you overwatch? Why don't you suppress? I don't think we're going to be revealing them this turn. Good work, good work. All right, Ben Paddon. Now you're going to want to ease up. Ease, mind you, don't go crazy. All right, yeah, no, just ease up, hunker down. I think that's our best vote here. And why don't you overwatch with a pistol, even though it might not do us too much good. I just need to make sure one of these maybe gets hit. Nope, he's not gonna get hit. In fact, he's gonna take a really good shot. Well, it was mediocre. It was like a 50, it was a coin flip. Okay, we scared one. That one's still on the loose, but he's potentially flankable by the... Good, good, okay. Lucky turn, I'll take it though. Now the only thing worse than this would be... Well, if basically the only thing worse than this would be... And I could blow them up. I could blow them up right now with my one rocket and then save the Shredder for everything else. I hear sectoids too, so that means we're probably gonna see a mechtoid pod potentially. You could also set one up for capture, though I don't know how I'm going to do that. Probably suppress one of them. Don't know how much of my my arc throwers I want to waste either on captures I don't particularly need right now. I really just need the mutons, and I don't even know if there are mutons on the map. So, yep. Maybe best to open with the rocket. Even though it removes our cover for the future, I'm hoping we won't need it. And I can go crazy now, and that'll be okay. Or we could see what other people have as options. We have disabling shots still. That's definitely a thing we've got. Yeah, damn, you suck. We're gonna have to keep suppressing you. I could start with a 72% with a sniper, or we could blow up the cover and give him a practically 100%. Don't know what I want to do with that. We'll see. You're gonna keep suppressing. Somebody's gonna start taking pot shots at that guy, or we could try to capture him. I don't know. He's just gonna be a tough cookie there. We'll have to run around and shoot him. That's alright. He's in a very vulnerable position. Chem's not going to be useful at all on these guys, I know that much. The flashbang I want to save. Jack Vernon could do some flanking. He could get up here and flank that guy and his life. But then we got to worry about this guy flanking Derek Vernon, which apparently he isn't. I don't know how that is the case, but it is. I guess you can't see him from there because of the tree. Go figure. Well, if he stays there, that won't be a problem.
Will do.
Now, actually, this is getting dangerously close to the rocket, and I probably should have decided whether or not I wanted to fire that first, but if I can spare it, I'm going to. Alright, no, definitely switch to the shotgun. Then we can run and gun this other dude and suppress the thin man so we just move. Great! That'll be a kill, I hope. Yep. It's a pretty solid kill, if I do say so myself. And hell, we could start getting flanks on that guy, too, and shoot him with some folk. We get two shots on this guy here. If we could get some hollow, that'd be great. You can run and gun this sucker, although, well, leaving you out in the open's not a smart move, is it, Ben Paddon? No, no. No, sirree, Bob, it is not, and you, my friend, are actually in no position to flank him at all. So, I'm wondering if that's a good idea. Alright, your mobility isn't very good, I forgot that little detail. It's okay. We might have to just blow him up. But at least we got rid of one so we can concentrate the fire on him. Yeah, we're gonna suppress that one up there that's hunkered. Can't really do much about the hunkered guy right now. The hunkered, Mr. Hunkered Games here. I think it would be stupid to move Craig Kearns in, but I'm not sure. I really need to take care of this guy. If we can take care of him with the sniper, that'd be good. I can use Ben Paddon as potentially a backup. And then if not, the rocket. I wanna try saving the rocket. Ah, damn it. That was a pretty okay shot, too, but hey. What can you do? We may have to use the rocket. But that's dangerous when I'm putting my troops up so close to this guy. That is dangerous as shit. And also, I realize that guy's gonna run if I flank him. So I'd have to... If he's gonna run the suppression, hopefully Krebs can hit him. I don't think any of them have lightning reflexes, but I'm not sure. Yes, this is a conundrum. It's a bit of a conundrum, indeed. Alright, well...
Going in for the kill.
I don't particularly like it, but I'm going to do it anyway.
Order's
I'm going to get up close
moving
and personal
out.
And try to hit him without being flanked to anybody. And now I'm flanking the other guy like I thought. 79%, 36% crit. Let's try it. I mean, it's not much better than this. No, damn, alright, Ben Paddon, that's fine. You do you, buddy. Holy hell. Holy hell. Alright, let's take care of baby
people.
Fark McGeezak here. Alright, good. Let's see if we can do a little damage to him. Good. Just a smidge of damage. We will suppress him. And then that'll be that.
Keep him down, Commander.
Hopefully. And then David Rice can, I guess, just take some pot shots or something. Or flashbang him, I don't know. 25%? Is that the best you got, man? Is that really the best you got? Sure, go for it. See what happens. Put him on Overwatch too, actually. That might be smarter. In fact, that's probably the smartest thing to do. Then we can do the same up here. Overwatch in this position. So basically we've got three Overwatches on this guy, and if he gets loose, one of them might hit. Oh, we could have four Overwatches on this guy if we wanted. If we truly felt that was necessary. I truly feel it's necessary, to be honest. This is gonna encourage him not to run at all. Go for it. Go, asshole. Oh, Krebs, yeah. That's right. Huh. Well, you know what? That definitely changed my opinion of Overwatch gunners right there. Yeah, Krebs, you've been doing good. I don't know why I have never considered the Overwatch build as a thing for you, or anybody, for that matter, but now I am. Because I realize it's pretty alright. It is a pretty alright build. Now, Melt. That's pretty cool. We could go for that. Though, if we activate any more aliens right now, we're not going to be prepared to take them on. Which would suck. So I may be kind of reserved here. Although I could throw my second and final battle scanner. No, I have three. That's right. So we could catch up a bit. Toss it forward to make sure that it's, like, okay to do this. To do this thing. Where's a good place? I mean, potentially here? Just so I know, like, what's going on around the corner. Yeah, maybe that. Maybe out there would be good. And then we'll try to save the rest. So I know if it's safe to move in on that meld. If not, we're going to try to take that high ground. God damn it. Of course. We're actually just barely outside of the range of these stupid sectoids. And a sectoids. Sectoids and an A commander. That's a pretty juicy pod, though. And I could get a sectoid capture because I need one for that request. The only problem with that is I don't know if there's going to be any mutons. I haven't heard any, for one. For two, it may be in our best interest to move back.
Solid copy.
Visual try not on the goods. To activate everybody right now.
Ready to rock.
I mean, I'm just saying that, but... hell.
Lista para atacar.
Not yet, Cal Budwine. Not just yet. We're going to take a turn here.
Good to go.
See if we can't avoid these A's.
Rock and roll.
Just a bit. Now I'm thinking I should move you forward for sure, because we might need you.
It's killing time.
Oh god, that A commander is gonna be a big deal. Let me tell you what.
Okay.
They're never fun.
Back online.
Like we'd have to prioritize killing that asshole too.
On Overwatch.
All right, which way are you gonna go? Okay, good. You're not gonna go my way per se, but you're gonna leave the battle scanner, which is a problem because that was the only way I could shoot you with Kyle Budwine. Now we're actually gonna have to activate on our own terms. Which is always a neat thing to do.
Ground control to Major Tom.
Kind of want to keep you here because... ah, wait. Can I do that? Can I activate with a shredder rocket and then that'll be that? I could have done that. I could have totally activated with a shred. That'd have been a good way to activate. And then I can run forward, get vision on him, and shoot the shit out of him. That would have been great. But I didn't do that. I don't know why I didn't do that. Well, alright, I can still do that. I can still shred. That's an idea. That's certainly an idea. It's just whether or not they run forward is the question, and I won't be able to destroy any of their cover either because I'm not using a rocket, I'm using a shredder. But, on the other hand, let's just watch some A's explode. I'm really into that. It's a good idea. Oh, that was a direct hit. One of those got 7 damage on him. That's super duper good. So I think it's 5. Big guy here. Oh, if only we could blow up your damn tree. Ooh, if only we could capture you. Should I acid you? Would that reduce your chances of mind controlling one of my soldiers? If so, I don't know. Alright, you can't see anybody. I guess there's a tree in the way. That happens. Don't worry about it. Pray the AOA. I guess that's the only solution, really. It really only ever was. Oh, Craig Kearns has suppression too. That's neat. That sure is cool. Now, I'm gonna have to be careful. very careful. If I acid him, I'm gonna have to make sure, you know, I have a way to wreck his shit when I'm ready. Because all those other A's are gonna be big trouble. I can feel it. I can tell you that much. And he is shredded, so now would be the turn to do some damage. Let me tell you what. I could get right up in his grill and shoot him. That is for true. I could just shoot him. And then try to eliminate him with everybody else. Everybody else. I really should just kill the commander, because I've got like four other little sectoids with him. Oh, sweet. I got a flank on one. Does that mean that Budwine has a flank on one? I wonder if I can actually get him some shots now. Ooh, he's got one. He does have one. It's 100%. That would probably kill it. I'd be okay with that. I mean, if you're not going to hit the commander, I don't see any reason why we shouldn't pick off these aliens right now. Good.
No longer a threat.
That one's down. You have only that one shot. You should maybe acid, possibly. You can suppress the commander. That one... I mean, that's not the most accurate shot I've ever seen. You're holding your shotgun like a pistol right now. I'm wondering if... You do have Ranger, too. That might work. We'll see. We'll see what we want to do. Yes, yes. And Kearns may have to smoke, but that, I don't know if I want to waste smoke on stupid sectoids. They don't do a lot of damage. Just if there's Psy, I have to be aware of. And if I smoke, they're probably just going to use Psy anyway. So what the hell's the point? There really isn't one. I really have to be careful with this guy. I really should be careful with this guy. Because if he does mind control me, it's going to be a hell of a time for everyone. Especially if he mind controls my assault. That's going to be even worse. And then if he mind controls him right there, then I can't explode him. So that's like the stupidest thing I could possibly do. I may want to just suppress him and pray. Now, if I go up here, I could potentially smoke a lot of things. Or very few. Ah, hello. I have a flank on another one. Wow, I'm flanking that guy. That idiot. He put himself out in the open. He's gonna run for sure. Damn, if only. If only I had some acid. That guy could be an easy capture. But, well, I can throw it. I can get it out of the assault's range. I can still acid this commander. And then run and gun the assault up. And then kill it. Potentially. That might be good. They might run to that log even. Who knows. Just try to get it as far back as possible. While also hitting the A commander. And on that log as much as I can. There's should be good. There should do the trick. And then we run and gun the assault. And we hope it all works out. I really should... My strategy should not hinge on hoping things work out. But at this point, you know... I'm hoping this whole campaign works out. So does that count? I forgot Ben Paddon has a deep, grizzly voice. They're all flanked. So they're all going to run. It would be stupid of them to not. 89%, 46% crit, acided, shredded. Let's give it a shot, Ben Pad, and see what you can do. Yeah, alright. Not great damage, actually, surprisingly, for that. So, I guess that's that. I guess that's a 9% chance to hit. That's great. That's really good. So I guess we'll suppress him, though he's probably just going to do some stupid mind control shit. Try to kill it. I don't know. You probably won't. Nah, you'll just do a lot of damage to it. Which is good. Yeah, if we just smoke, they're gonna shoot at us. That's no good. That's no good for super spies. But if I sit in half cover, they're just gonna do the same.
Aye, aye, Commander.
Could double suppress this dick. Could try that.
Aye, Commander.
I don't know what that's going to do, or if suppression even affects. Hello, I have a. Oh no, no, I don't. No, I do not. I don't have a shot on the other one. It just says I do, but I don't. Let's see. I mean, he might run. I don't know. Probably not. He's not flanked. He has no reason to run, but he is acided. I think that might reduce his will. I'm not sure. We'll give it a try. If they run forward, we'll maybe get him on some overwatches. I don't know. Nope, not running to the acid. In fact, he's just running to full cover. What's it gonna be then? Oh, shit. All right. Well, you can't mind control panicked soldiers, I think. Oh, no. Oh no. Oh no. Come on, guy. Really? Come on. I mean, come on. Guys. Guys, this is disappointing. Like, what would your mothers say? You've all failed me. Especially you, Ben Paddon. What the hell was that? 80%? I mean, damn. Damn, girl. Well, Maybe rocket time. I mean, a 35% ain't nothing I want to be. Ain't no shot I want to be taking. I mean, does nobody? I guess the scouts got hollow. And why did I have a 30% with the infantry all of a sudden? Oh, I guess I just got that for some reason. Now, two 30%s, and then still no shot with Budwine, who has no snapshots. That's great. Alright. May as well start taking two 30s. Good shot. Alright, great. That guy's dead. Although, my soldiers are all panicked. And potentially just flankable. So, we'll just move up, and then will we steady? Will we hunker? I don't know, because that's half cover against sectoids. I would hunker if I were a smart man, but I'm really not that smart. So, as you've seen. Oh, you're going to mind merge. Fuck you. You little assholes. Oh, this guy. This guy's the leader. He's the leader of the Three Stooges. I need to chem them so bad, but also I need to save my other chem. Oh, you're a little dick muffin. Oh, I hope you die. No. Somebody else want to catch that? Ah, it's okay. You didn't have to. Oh, yes, please do that. Please do that, Krebs. Krebs! No, Krebs. Oh, you had me like... I was so proud of you. Ah, it's all right. Ben Paddon doesn't care. It is all good in the hood. Although, it's not great. It's not great in the hood. Ooh, I hear a Muton. Yep, that's the capture right there. That's what we're going to go for. If it's a Berserker, actually, then never mind. I am an idiot. Now, what should we do? Well, Ben Paddon is not going to be able to run and gun. The best he can do is gun. I would send him, like, over here to shoot that sectoid, and then potentially send the scout up to do some other stuff. We may as well hide. That's my guess. That's my, bet I'm hedging. But before we do... let's go ahead and give this guy a little surprise, because he doesn't know that I have 100% shot on him with a sniper. Oh, cruel fate. Why are you cruel? I don't know. Stop judging me. Don't make fun of how I live. Alright. Well, we definitely have to run that Overwatch with the scout, so we will do that. We will for sure do that. That'll trigger it for shorezies. Though, does he have increased accuracy because of that mind merge? That mind merge is really what's killing me right now. I don't like it.
Rolling out.
Ah, hell. You can do it. I believe in you, Derek Vernon. Of all the scouts, I mean, scouts have had terrible luck recently, but that's no reason you should get hit by a 3% shot, right? I mean, my scouts have had abysmal luck. They have been getting blown the fuck out left and right here. And that is saying something. Yeah, we should just overwatch you, because that's what you're good at. Though if you keep failing me like this, I'm going to second-guess myself there. On my initial assessment that you were good. Alright. Yeah, you know what? Die. I don't need your shit today, Mr. Sectoid. You need to get back, Adonis Smith. You are in no fighting shape. You're in not much shape at all. Vasquez probably still shouldn't, like, be in the lead here. I should be very careful about what I do right now. I can get real crafty with these overwatches, but only so crafty. Vasquez should probably stand here, if anything. And I can stand the medic up here, though I don't know how much, like, mind fraying I want to undergo right now. This Psy Panic shit just kind of, like, threw a wrench in my plans. Whatever plans I had have a wrench in them now. Well, let's see what we can see. Just one, huh? Where's the other one? Where did he go? What's his play? Oh, I mean, what's his play? I don't know. I don't know what his play is, and I'm scared. But I know what my play is. Now, 68% is not the best shot I've ever seen. Hey, but Budwine's worth... forget it. He's dead. That's what I'm trying to say. No catchy catchphrases from me. No, sir. We just have that one sectoid left to deal with. No, he went the opposite direction, which I thought he did. I thought he was going to wrap around up here and try to hit me. Ooh, you've got one health left. Oh, that'd be great if I could capture you. What are you going to do? Hey, don't get any funny ideas. Oh, you didn't. It's okay. Hey, I don't blame you. Well, unfortunately, Don Smith's too far away to capture, and I should really save all my captures for mutons. Who needs kills? You kind of do, but that's what it is. You're going to level up anyway, I hope, if you survive. Ha! It's funny because I haven't been surviving missions recently. That's not funny. Kyle Budwine's out of shots. I do need scouts with some, even though you're gonna level up, but I do need scouts with some gumption, you know.
Solid copy.
Let's hope there aren't mutons right around the corner. Ha! That was a funny joke, because there might have been, and I didn't know. Alright, just kill it. We're not gonna capture it. Forget it. He's not worth our time. We got bigger fish to capture.
Commencing countdown, engines on.
There's something out there.
Okay, now might be a good time to potentially use the motion tracker, our last motion tracker, to get, you know, just a bit of an idea. Okay, yeah, so that things are different now. Things have changed. War has changed, in fact. Like, I don't even know what's what anymore. I mean, one of these things is on its own out, like, around this corner. I don't even know what it is. And then some other things are down that hallway, which could potentially actually be the outsiders. And, you know, based on what is going on here, I would say that's a safe bet. Well, okay, let's think about this. So if they're, well, okay, let me actually do math the right way. So if this is our leftmost dot, yes, then the outsiders are probably, like, actually, like, right in this hallway, probably not actually inside this room. If those are, in fact, the outsiders, I'm not even sure if they are, to be honest with you. I don't even know if we'll see what's over there if we open this door, based on everything that's happening. I don't know why this pod is so spread out. I really don't, and it pisses me off that it is. Because I know that's what boned me last time, but at least we have full cover here to work with. So I think here might be still the best place, so I'm gonna do it, even if that's stupid.
Enemy spotted.
What is it then? Yeah, see, this shit again. They're just spread out in a ridiculous way. Oh, God. Oh, what are you? You're big and scary, and I don't like it. Okay, so now none of those were the outsiders, in fact. In fact, they're not even close by. That one floater back there. That one muton behind this wall. And then somebody around this corner who we should probably kill. If we were smart men, we would. But I don't know if he's overwatching, so I'm gonna have to send the scout out to see. And I see no reason to, like, reserve that.
Moving.
So let's get Derek Vernon around this corner. See if he can dodge an overwatch from a floater who's right there, as I expected. Yeah, dick. I knew you were there the whole time. You don't have to tell me that. Oh, okay, I know where the outsiders are now. So it looks like we've got outsiders in that back corner, so we just need to not go there. And then we got the two floaters in the back who... I'm not really sure what they're gonna do yet, but I just need to eliminate that guy. Great start trying to eliminate him. I suppose you gave it your all. Now, is this a good idea if we wanna, like, not activate outsiders? I mean, how far back are they? I can still look at the motion tracker, right? Even if I click on your deactivated body, yes. Well, that's a tough call. I mean, from here, they weren't even visible, so I assume that means I'll be alright. And they look even farther back in the corner, so it looks like they're behind that wall. I'm gonna do it. Unless Anna Vasquez's rocket scatters so far back that she actually accidentally, like... Then again, maybe I should just leave. Yeah, come to think of it, it could be a better idea to leave this wall shut and then just deal with this muton on his own. I know I'll be depriving the other one of cover, but then, like, what do we do about this guy? He's pretty big and scary. I don't know if I like that. But we do need to capture them, so I don't know what the best way to do that is. Alright, let's get reckless. Let's give him a goddamn show. If this is gonna be one of our last shows, we may as well make it pretty. Hello. How are you doing today? Uh-oh. Looks like you left your cover at home, sir. Ah, damn it. And of course the gunner has nothing. He has no shot. He never does. Okay, you're the only one the sniper can see, so I don't see why not just get rid of that floater right now. Nice, that one's dead. Now I need to consider how we're gonna get rid of these mutons. The answer. I ain't got an idea. I ain't got no ideas at all. I got nothing. I mean, we know that one's easy meat, and I can run and gun up here, up close to this one, and shoot him. But then that leaves the question, well, then how are we gonna capture a muton? Yes. That old question, Super Spaz. Well, let me tell you how we're gonna do it. We're gonna have to suppress him somehow, and since you can't, and obviously Ben Paddon's gonna have to be taking some shots here. Where from? I don't know. I got nothing. If he's flanked, that's bad. I don't want him to leave him flanked. We gotta kill that one Muton. So I'm gonna do that with someone who can and has to. God damn it. God damn it. I can try flashbanging him. Try flashbanging them both, actually. Can't I? I can do that. I think that'll hit both of them. Oh yeah, Will. I can flashbang the Mutons. That might make captures even better. I mean, that one's gonna run. I may want to move forward to do it, but I don't know how safe I can make this. Do I want to give this spot to somebody else? I don't know. I need to suppress that Muton too, but not too close. And not flank to any floaters. That would be bad. It would be abysmal. I should have snapshotted that rocket so I could give the spot to you. But now you're going to have to take a half cover, and you can't smoke either. Alright, you may as well take a shot and flashbang. So I guess kill that one and then flashbang the last one, and then we'll try to capture that one. Eh, I don't know. It's not a great plan, but it's the only one I got. Yeah, alright. Why not? I'm gonna do that.
Start keeping score.
I mean, I don't know how bad this is gonna get, really. I'd have loved to save the flashbang for the outsiders, but we still have chem for them. That's alright. That'll at least make them really easy to kill. Which, well, I'm not gonna... I guess I'll just worry about getting that Muton captured because we need soldiers big time. And I guess we could put you here to cap to suppress, but then you'd have a... I don't know if you'd have a better shot from there or from there. So I'm gonna go from here and suppress. Suppress you.
Bring in the pain.
And then we'll shotgun him, bring it on his Smith forward. And potentially just wrap this all up in a new bow.
Rolling.
Potentially. And a bow. 51%. Are you kidding me? Would it be better if you were here with no cover? No, it wouldn't. Man, dude, I mean, fine. I won't like it, but do it. Ah, God, Jesus, guys.
Missed.
Jesus. Cheese and rice. Cheese and rice, my friends. That is terrible. Terrible. Terrible, my friends. Ugh, my goodness. What are you doing? Oh. So that's good. He's disoriented and suppressed. Hopefully, yeah, 1%. Good. Good those aren't hitting today. We gotta just figure out how we're gonna capture this asshole, because now this guy's here, and he's ready to party. Luckily, I believe my infantry is ready to party right back. I think. 55%. God damn it, guys! Scout is hollow, right? Maybe I should do that. Maybe. Potentially, yes. Eh, fine. Good hit. Solid hit. We can send the scout in to take care of the rest of it. I hope. I just really need to know how we're going to take that Muton. And capture it. Also. Because the where it is right now, it's only got like... Man, that is stupid. That is a stupid place for you to be. Alright, that one's definitely dead if I send my scout in here. I think it will probably see me coming though. I hate to leave the scout in half cover here. And then if you get shot by a floater, like, what do I do?
Affirmative.
I could throw a smoke over there, I guess. Okay, yeah, that's what I figured.
Got a lot of heat
no,
on me.
Not today. We're not doing this today. Derek Vernon is a scout who will survive this time, I hope. I mean, that's really up to him, of course.
Got him.
Whether or not he actually wants to, you know, that's entirely up to you. What do we got then? That last floater in the hallway, this guy, this jokester. And if I put Ben Paddon here, and then he's flanked, he's gonna run. I don't want him to run. I really don't want him to run. Yeah, that could be potentially good. Why don't we do that? It'll keep us kind of safe from anything that might come our way. So the assault runs and guns up here. Or just runs. He doesn't necessarily have to gun. Because I don't know if that's gonna kill the shit out of him or not. I may just run him instead, just to flank him. So he runs that overwatch and knows it's not safe to go that way. Uh-oh. Hey guys, I found the other floater. He's right there. He was not in any position to flank us, thank God, but he did something stupider. Now, as to where we are going to put Adonis Smith, I don't know. Yeah, again, not sure. It's a toss-up. It's faux shizzle. 41% to hit, and then you're gonna be capturing, so you need to get to a place where you're gonna potentially capture him. Where is that, though? I'm not sure. It's a hell of a day, though. Wait, what? Oh, I guess you can see him. That's alright, you're probably not gonna hit an Overwatch anyway. Let's just steady you. And then, where do you want to go? Like, what's your play, man? You need to think. And we need to not go over there because I'm sure that's where the outsiders are. Yeah, let's just hunker you so you don't die. You're pretty fragile. Alright, what's your play, buddy? Gonna run? That's right. Alright, Krebs. Get him down to like two. Ah, oh, Krebs, goddammit. Too good! Too good! God damn it, Krebs. I was hoping that wouldn't completely trounce that Muton. And then you did. And then you went and trounced him. You trounced him dead. You trounced him so hard. I guess we're doing outsider captures now, but we don't have any flashbangs anymore. All we've got is Chem.
Check ignition and may God's love be with you.
No way you did this. I can't believe you've done this. This is utterly ridiculous, and I won't be a part of it. So, should we throw the battle scanner into this room, perhaps? I don't know. It might be a good idea.
I'm on the move.
We'll see. I kind of want to get the sniper set up. But not too set up, you know what I'm saying? Because if I get him, like, too close, we could have a real party on our hands. A real death party. And I don't like death parties. They scare me. God damn it, why are you doing this to me? I do not like it one little bit. Okay, good. I can throw from there, and then that means I can run up and do things and
come again.
Well, that damn floater's in that direction, so we should probably fortify in that direction. This is full cover, I guess. I'm not arguing that. I'm not disputing it. Oh, dear God, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, hell no. We're getting the fuck out of here. Oh, I got played, suckers. I got played. They weren't in that room at all. It wasn't ever safe. It was never safe. I was completely, utterly wrong. Oh, shit. I got played. So how do we play back? Well, short answer. I don't think we can. Because this guy... I'm pretty sure this guy has the mobility to get right here and flank us if he really wants to. So we really can't take a position over here, which is a bummer. Ooh, that is shitty. Now, luckily, they can't see our engineer, so he's kind of safe, I hope. Oh, you crafty foxes. Oh, you've got me. I can suppress one, but I don't know how safe that's going to be in any sort of environment. It could be best to go here with the scout, although he's putting himself seriously at risk of being shot in the face. And I don't like that risk. I do not like risking that, especially when I have no suppression to back myself up. I got played like a fool. I thought they were in there. It was too good to be true. I should have known. Should have known that's not how it was. We just need to run the fuck away. That's what we need to do. I'll get the infantry out here.
Already there.
How far can Anna Vasquez escape to... I hope her mobility is pretty high. It's not. Not at all. Not even remotely good enough. I can't even get you back to full cover in out here. I mean, I can get you behind the wall, but that's the best I can do, and honestly, I don't even think that's good enough, because they'll just run outside and kick your ass. I need to think of a good way to get you out. Scout, too. Scout needs to leave. But he also can't. He's also stuck. Verily. I could put him here. That would at least make him safe to any flanks from the side by the outsider. Plural. Our gunner could cover our escape here a bit. And suppress that one. I don't know where they're going to... The other one's probably just going to run up to here and shoot him then. So we can't let that happen. Not really. Oh, Christ. And we're out of smokes. We are straight up out of those. No more of that happening.
Run.
Medic, get back. Ben Paddon, get the hell out of there. We got played. It's three of them now. There's three outsiders in this one. That's bad. They upgraded too soon, too fast, too furious. You know, to be honest, it was probably our two bodies that we left behind that got them that upgrade. That's not good. It's really bad that you can't escape. I mean, the best you can do is get here, but you're still inside of them. And that's not good. That's not what we want. That's not what anybody wants. The second best is, like, here. So I would have to leave somebody behind to cover you. Honestly, I'd rather have full cover over that any day. I mean, you can shoot a rocket and run, but no, you can't even run. You can't shoot the rocket and run. You can just shoot the rocket. We might want to have you be here so you can shoot the rocket, but we have no way to decrease their accuracy, so they're going to have some pretty accurate shots against us, to be honest. Which is a pain in the ass. Which is a real pain in the dick. Pain in my squirrely, squirrely little ding-dong. Oh, Willy Wonka, you amazing chocolatier, what do we do? What the hell do we do, man? It's a madhouse out there. I swear. Now, you actually can't see that outsider, which is cool because, like, he's a lower elevation, he's blocked. I don't know if he's going to come up to a place where he can see us, or if it's even safe to stay here, considering where these outsiders are. And if he go there, you're just going to get flanked. In fact, you're just probably going to be flanked anyway. So I guess I'm going to suppress you, I suppose. Roger, I don't have a choice. Ah, damn, that sucks. Damn, this is bad. This is bad, bad, bad. This is like, boy, what is bad? What is just, like, remember that septic tank I was talking about earlier? Now it's overflowing, that's for sure. I did not activate on my terms at all. I activated, like, half on their terms. I should have used the battle scanner when I had the chance and realized, uh-oh, they're not in there. I gotta rethink my strategy. They're probably in that hallway. So what do? I should have sandwiched them, and then I could have had this in the bag, but I didn't do that at all. I did the opposite. I assumed they were in the place I thought they were. I assumed I was smart. I assumed I was loyal. But it turns out I'm not. I am stupid and not good at this game. Alright. And I'm worried that if I go here, I'm going to get seen by him. So I don't want to do that. I don't want to stay here. I can't. I simply don't have that option. I know that one's going to move here. He's going to flank himself, but he is... gonna take a shot. Well, you know what? Would they do that? Is that something they would do? Are outsiders like that ballsy that they would flank themselves? He might go here.
That's affirmative.
I don't know. You can just hunker down. That might work. That might scare them enough. And then you'll be good to move in on the next turn. And our scout can take this position right here, where he hopefully won't be seen by anyone important. I mean, that's the hope. That's the thing about hopes, is that they are not always... Oh god. Oh, this is a bad time for old Super Spaz. What are you doing? Oh, you can just take cover there, I guess. Oh my god. Alright. We need to go bigger. We need to go... Oh no. Oh god. Oh god. Oh no. No. Oh no. Oh, God. Well, at least they're not overwatching. Oh, right. So, what's the plan now? Run back into the forest? Retreat? Get the fuck out of here? All of these and more this time on fuck this shit, I'm out. I'm done. I'm not doing this anymore. We done here. We are out. We are bailing. I gotta bail. I don't have the manpower to take on these outsiders, to be honest. Even if I did, like, my shred can't stay here, because that one's just going to kill me in the middle. I have no protection against them right now. I wasted it all. So I have to run. I simply have to run away. Can I run away to a safe place? Nope. No, our gunner's too slow. Our gunner's way too slow. Well, we can't stay and fight. Well, we can stay and fight. That's actually true. We can stay and fight. That's totally an option. I just have to have a way... to basically not die when I decide to stay and fight. And really, there's not too many ways we can do that, I'm afraid. We can't blow up their cover. They're as in cover as they're gonna be. Our sniper does have a couple flank shots on him, and hell, I could even disable one if I wanted. No, it's an 80% chance to disable that one. Alright, fine. We're not retreating. That's not happening. We're not doing that. I'm doing something much, much stupider. I am fighting back. Lord, please have mercy on my stupid decision. I really hope you can find it in your heart to forgive me. Okay, so now what we're going to do, I guess, is I would suppress that middle one with our... Oh god, I have to suppress him with my medic in half cover. That's good. That's gonna go over well, I'm sure. You have to acid that crowd right now. You have to acid them right fucking now. We're not capturing them. No, no. No, that's not happening. No, no. We have to kill them all. We have to run in there. We have to shotgun one of them, I guess. And then... I don't know. I have to disable one of... Not the floater. Floater's not dangerous. You're dangerous. I need to disable you. Would it be better if I just tried to kill him, though? I don't know. A 90% chance... They're shredded, potentially going to be chemmed in a second. It may just be smarter. It may. I don't mean that it will, but it may be smarter. And then how many can you suppress? All of them? No, you can suppress that guy, though. That might be better. And then I can suppress the other one with the medic, which might be a little tiny bit less dangerous. But that's up in the air, really. I just need to get swifty, that's all. That's all I gotta do is just get swifty. That's all I gotta do is just get swifty and then pray that nobody dies. Because if everybody dies, well then, hey, what have I accomplished today? I just need to make sure they don't take shots at you. Anybody else would be fine. So perhaps it would be in our best interest to try and disable that guy, because I don't think a sniper shot's gonna do it, and a shotgun blast might not either. I need to get in there, I need to throw a chem. Hopefully it'll be enough to disorient them. Scare them also, they'll be flanked. I know it won't affect the outsiders, but it'll at least, like, screw with them a bit. It'll be partial fuckery. And I need to also make it so the assault has a place to take cover, or a couple. That should be good. Great. I don't know if that shred acid sniper's gonna work. I mean, you have a flank on him. You have a 62% chance to crit that thing. I don't know if disabling or if shooting is the better option here. And that's a big choice to make right now. I mean, the shotgun's definitely gonna blow the face off that thing. I'm just worried about the floater, to be real with you. So maybe I should shoot the floater with the sniper, because I know that'll kill it. And then shoot the outsider with the shotgun, suppress, and then pray to God. Yeah, I guess that's the better choice, is to not go for the outsider, but go for the shotgun crit acid shred on the outsider, and hope it dies. It's also a flank, so I mean, hey. Okay, floater down. Salt, you need to go. You need to... I know, it's crazy. Right? You're getting right up in their faces. You could die. Like, that's not a joke. Dude, that's too real.
Yes, sir.
And then the medic needs to suppress that outsider. Hopefully, he'll take a shot at the outsider and not me, because he's not flanked. 96% chance to crit. Come on, baby. Do the chimichanga. That's the way. Alright, here we go. This is gonna... I feel something calling in the air tonight, oh lord. Suppress him. Don't make me regret giving you suppression, goddammit, Kearns. This is for Karina, my friend. This one is for fucking Karina. Okay, that was unintentional. And also kinda, I guess, true. Oh, dammit, what do I do with you? Where can you go? Oh, cruel fate. Why have you done this to me? Because, yeah, David Rice, you were in no position to do anything at all. Well, you can go here and take a couple shots on that outsider and half cover next turn, right? You can do that. Hey. Nope, you can't. And then the scout needs to start moving in to get rid of that guy. If possible. I don't know if it is. Because I think the assault can handle this one on his own. Gee, I hope. And then that's that. I don't want to get too close, because that's like baiting a shark. That's baiting a goddamn shark right there. Because if he runs forward... I mean, he's suppressed, he shouldn't run. He shouldn't run forward. But I've seen crazier things happen. This guy's also not acided. I just need to get ready to take that guy on. What are you going to do? Who are you going to shoot? I don't know. Oh, no. Oh, no, he's doing the thing. He's doing a thing. He's doing a bit. He's running. Oh, God. That was surprisingly not accurate. Oh, right, the acid. I think it messed with him a bit. That's good. Oh, great. Oh, no. Oh, God. What do I do? Well, now what? Now who takes care of this guy? Because you, although you may be able to see him, you don't have a great shot. The scout is not anywhere close. He can't help. Yeah, no. You're going to have to suppress that middle guy again. Unfortunately. I mean, hey, that's kind of what you're here for, right? I think. We really need to destroy that cover, but we can't, so that's fine. Alright, we can flank him. Right, we can do that. No, yes, yes, we can. And he has holo targeting, so he can give the sniper a potentially better shot. We're just gonna be leaving two people in open cover. Ha!
Good to go.
This is insane. This is actually nuts. So I should open with the scout and give holo so that 87 actually becomes a 97. And then I can maybe get a really clutch shot on him. The only issue I have with this is that the other outsider might be able to see me. Shit, and I could maybe capture him too. Shit, that's crazy. Nah, I'm just out of range for that. I don't want to do that. That's stupid. That's a dumb idea. I should just kill it. I should just kill this honky. It's really not worth my time. Actually, I don't think here would be a flank, would it? Because you have to technically step out. And then when you stand right next to the cover, it's not a flank. I may as well just get really close to him. Fine, man. You win. I got you. What's our chance to stun? Zero? That's best shot I've had all day. All right. Let's get that holo on you then. Yeah, because fuck you. Fuck you. Oh, he's so dead. He's so dead. The assault should have him in the bag right now. Which means our sniper can focus on something else. Okay, good. Now, just one outsider. So far, nobody's dead. Mai, you need to get out. You need to go away. You're not going to be any help out there. Now I need to get Swifty.
Moving out.
I need to put you in here. Put you in the game. Try shooting at him. I don't know. It might work. If it does, then I could send the scout in and shoot him and then finish this thing. But no. Nah. That ain't how it is. That is not how this works today. Now, I think I can go here with the sniper and it's going to be all right. I think he'll... Because I couldn't see him there before, so he shouldn't be able to see me. Good. Perfect. Now, you're not going to be able to suppress, but you are going to be able to get the element of surprise on him in the coming turn.
Okay.
I hope. Or something.
Let's rock.
Or something to that effect. 73% chance with shot. Hell, let's just do it. Give some... Oh, I could have given holo before. Oh, well. 32. That is too good. Too good chance. Ah, you scary. You big scary man. All right. Now things have gotten a bit interesting. Now this probably won't kill him. To be honest with you, we have no reliable way to capture these outsiders. We really should just kill this guy and run. How many good chance to hits do I have? None? Okay, good luck everybody else. 63, and with holo from the scout, that'll be a 73. I have two potentially 58%. I have one potentially 70%. I have a lot of shots on that guy that might be pretty good, and then a really good shot from Craig Kearns by getting close. So I think our best move is to run with the scout, shoot him with the shotgun, hollow him up, and then just try to finish this stupid Yahoo before he causes us any more pain. Well, I hope that's how it goes down. I don't know. We'll see. Good. Good first hit. I don't expect the second to hit, but hey, how close are you to leveling? I mean, we are putting a lot of our chalk in one thingy, as it were. Oh boy.
That's a load of.
Okay, what do you got then? Because I suppose if all else does fail, we should really suppress him again. I get close range suppress him, but that's really stupid. Hell, try to take 4 health off him with that. I doubt it'll work. Oh, dude! Oh, no bueno, no bueno, no bueno, no bueno, no bueno, no bueno. No, 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 si, no, 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 no. No, it's no bueno, it's no bueno. We actually potentially have shots with everybody, so I may as well just do that if this is the plan. 75! Do it, Vasquez. Alright, he's got two health left. He is perfect for capturing, but I can't capture him, because of the way it is. Just because of the way it is. That's just not going to happen. I mean, hey, Adonis Smith all the way out there. He is in no shape to do this thing. I mean, even if I could sprint your lily ass out there, I doubt it would work. Okay. All right, let's try the 58 on the pistol and the 58 on the big gun. Oh, Jesus. Okay. Oh, God. Oh, God, thank you. All right, that was a bad mission. Or it went kind of south at the end there, because poor Vasquez just got blown the fuck out by that outsider. That's the only thing that went wrong. I don't think anybody took health damage besides her. And that's good, because I already don't have a lot of Rocketeers in sickbay. Oh, that's right, I do. How long's she out for, Doc? Oh, let me guess, like 40 days? because I rolled bad on the end of the whole two health left spectrum. 44 days, yeah, I was right. I was very right. Derek Vernon got fatigued. Kearns got promoted, though. Hooray. I guess I would do paramedic for you, although smoke grenade is a great perk and all. Paramedic is what I would go for because you can use a medkit, then fire. And that's, with revive, that's really good. So I will give you paramedic. You know, God forbid. It gets worse. And you are a ranger, holo-targeting weirdo scout? I don't even know what you're supposed to be. I guess I want to start replacing with aggression then concealment, because you've got holo, ranger. I don't really want to do flush. I could do battle scanners, I guess. I don't know. What would be better? Ah, hell, let's just give you aggression. I feel like that's just the best. Come on, man. You got to replace your fellow scouts here. You got a legacy to live up to. And we got no captures, so that was great. That went well. Yeah, it's getting worse. It is getting much worse. It's all my fault, of course. That's a lot of money. That's good, we need that. Got any extra Seeker Rex anymore? I don't think we do. Yeah, only 7. I mean, the mech, I'll have like one mech, and then she won't even be constantly in rotation. That's right, that's what I was gonna do. I was going to do something to somebody who just got blown the fuck out for 44 days. Oh no, who was gravely wounded. Okay, Tettle Todd. So you're an Overwatch Rocketeer. And as I discovered, they are what they are. Now, unfortunately, as a sergeant, you're going to get shot back into, not a gunnery sergeant. So you're going to be shot back to what, corporal? Oh God. And you're all, oh, man, you were so close. That's unfair. Might be better to do to Anna Vasquez. And then Tettle Todd will just have to level up a bit more. Because at least we'll have her back. She'll be useful. But I don't know if I want to make Anna Vasquez a... Well... Hell, I don't know. Like, who's a better Rocketeer here? Vasquez has better mobility. Not as good aim as Tettle Todd. Tettle Todd's will is going to take a hit too. Only 5, though. I may eventually make her an archer anyway. We just gotta decide who we want to do now. Make an archer. It would probably be better to make Anna Vasquez an archer. Oh my god, because she loses that rank. So I'm gonna do that.
Once the required amputations have been completed,
I hope that doesn't bite me in the ass. And the other thing about archers too, they're not great to field early. And I'm hoping I'll get money enough to build that thing I want to build for them. I really should, damn. I may want to augment somebody to make them into a Pathfinder. Who to do that to? Dale Watson. I gotta keep my... honestly, I have nobody I can afford to make a Pathfinder. Marble can't even because he's an officer. I can't afford Pathfinders right now. I just can't. It can't happen. And I guess that means Twilight Duck is gonna have to be a scout, even though I don't like that prospect. But that's probably how it's gonna go. Because I'm sure on whatever mission comes next, I'm gonna need one. Alright. And then how are we doing in the air game? I remember it wasn't great. Yeah, it wasn't great. It was not good. It was not phantasmic. Scan for exalt 2 days.
Aircraft transfer complete.
Was it a bombing or was it... No! No! What the hell? Alright, this scan for exalt mod doesn't quite work well. I mean, I went immediately last time. That's not even right. That's not even correct. Alright, sorry about that. I got sidetracked by something, or interrupted. So let's see, we got 4 interceptors. Dear. Well, hell, I may want to send one back to North America, because it looks like North America's kind of like our dump here. But who'd send? Probably a laser cannon. Even though Asia's going to be taking the big hits here. Hell. Nah, I should send him now. Let's send Pancake over here to North America, because I want at least 3 fighters up there in case we get, like, a barrage of baddies. Okay, well, hey, Exalt got us. So, let's, well, I guess we may as well go on a covert operation in Russia. Hey, we don't have to pay for a scan. So, yeah, we just got boned by Exalt, and, well, to be honest, it didn't matter. Russia was already at max panic. But it could have mattered. And I'm beginning to think that this whole mod doesn't work, and now I'm gonna have to keep track of things normally. So I would say 7 days to the day after an operation, definitely scan for Exalt. I've reset the mod, so it should warn me in 7 days from now on, but I mean, I should play it really safe. I had it to warn me in 8 days, and I usually scan a day before, as you see.
What's going on down there?
Bradford.
Tell those guys we can't have them bringing down the walls in the name of prototype testing.
Okay, here's the problem, though. I'm pretty sure we're out of assaults. If not assaults that can actually do anything. Oh, yeah. We are, we are not good shape here. Like, all our assaults are either wounded, gravely wounded, or just out of action. We have one assault. No scouts. So this Exalt operation is going to be very hairy, if I do say so myself. In fact, I'm sorry, what? I can't put Paddon in? Why not? I think you can send fatigue soldiers, can you not? I thought you could. I guess you can't. Nope, I guess you can't. That's bad. On the bright side, I don't think they'll do another operation, although the cell might disappear within 92 hours, so that's a problem. I can't just ignore Exalt. I may have to just scan again afterwards anyway. So I wouldn't have had an assault or a scout to actually do this job, apparently. That's good. That's what I want. Yeah, I guess no, you can't send fatigued soldiers on Exalt missions, apparently. That's good. That's just what I needed. It's gonna tell me to scan. I know that. I know what they already did their thing.
Our tracking terminal to play civilization? At least hope you're going for a military victory.
Oh, I could do it to Mama Duck. I could make her a scout, but then she wouldn't be very good. She'd just be a scout, she wouldn't be an assault. She'd at least have lightning reflexes to run overwatches, but that's a dangerous game I'm playing right there. That is a dangerous game. With no concealment, that is especially dangerous. That is especially crazy dangerous. I mean, geez, Louise, man. She's our last hope. So do I want to make her an assault or do I want to make her a scout? How many assaults do we have? We have 5 assaults. We have 3 scouts. I need more scouts. Alright, Big Mama. I'm afraid the time has come for you to prove you've got the right stuff. My god, I hope you've got the right stuff. So what kind of scout do we want you to be? Well, we definitely want you to eventually be concealment if you make it that far. Huh. It's a joke. You're gonna make it just fine. I could do low profile. I could do lone wolf low profile for like a good... That would be a good covert op build, I think. Lone Wolf might be a waste. I might do Hollow instead. Yeah, let's do Hollow, Low Profile, then Battle Scan, Concealment, Sprinter, Smoke and Mirrors. Just a general support build, and then you'll become a Pathfinder later. I think I like that. I think so. So let's do it. Let's go ahead and do these things. You have no health. That's... Sure, why not? Why the hell not? Why not have any health? All right. Covert operations. Let's go ahead and do that with Twilight Duck, who is a scout. Oh, God save you. I really hope this doesn't go south for you. Now, let's go ahead and give you the last alloy plating, because you have no health, like I said. You're just going to have to be really fast and not die. That's just the way the news goes, I'm afraid. Laser pistol alloy plating. I'm not going to give you an alien. Like, you need to be able to move. So that's gonna be it. Twilight Duck, good luck.
Xcom operative deployed.
Good luck out there.
Position in
Russia. I'm so boned. I am so boned. I have no scouts. I'm so boned. I can't even actually bring a scout
aircraft
on the next mission.
Transfer.
Take those 6 days. Yeah, you know, we got a lot of waiting to do. I hope the aliens are just like slow on the uptake here. Sweet deal. Alright. Awesome. We got that mech suit. So that's done. We have a mech now. We just need somebody to go inside it, which will be in a couple of days, if not 16 hours. Hey, what do you know? 16 hours till mechs, baby. Let's see if it hits.
Online.
Oh, sweet. All right. I have no money, but boy, would I like to buy a. I can start excavating for another lab. We do need to crank the labs up here. So let's do that. Let's actually start excavating. I should have done that sooner. I don't know why I didn't think to do that sooner, but hey. Let's see if danger actually, like, comes in. Should I keep the music? It's a cutscene anyway, but I'm going to play music over it. You know what I'm going to play. It should be obvious at this point. Danger?
The cybernetic interface.
Oh, no. Guys.
Without a cyber suit to interface with.
I think, I think we might have a problem. I think she's...
I suggest we manufacture...
Are you... did we... Did we research stealth? Guys, what did you... Oh my god. Wait, she's up there. She's up... Look. She can fly. Oh my god. What have we created? Man was not meant to harness this technology. We've created flying robots. Well, all right then. Well, that is pretty awesome. I think Danger's gonna turn this whole thing around for us. I needed that. I needed that. That was great. That was perfect. That was just what we needed. Alright, guys.
Our cyber suits have faced the
trials of battle. This says ghost grenade. Whoops.
As we continue to deploy our mech troopers.
So we built one of these, Commander. It's not a robot, but
and if fortune is with
hope
us,
it works.
Help put an end to this conflict.
What I'm thinking, obviously we would pick Light 'em Up as our first perk. I mean, it's got some tough competitors, but you know, that's just it's just my thoughts on the matter. You could there's three ways you can build Valkyries. One way is an Overwatch Valkyrie, so I would go like automated threat assessment, because that's the one that is for Overwatch, I think, yeah. Or I would go, if you wanted to do damage Overwatch, do Ranger, rapid reaction, lock and load, that or Shredder, I don't know, lock and load, opportunist, repair servos, absorption fields? I don't know about that. I'm not gonna do Overwatch Valkyries, I think. That's probably best left to somebody like a... I'd say the Goliath's best at Overwatch, because you just do, like, you just park in the middle of all the enemies, and then they're really close to you, and then when they move, because you have close combat specialists, when they move, you automatically get a shot on them. So you just, like, you're getting close range bonuses, you're getting your Overwatch bonuses, you go crazy if you can actually manage to park your Goliath in the middle of the enemy. That's all I know about that. As for Overwatch mechs, I never really used them for that. I used them for busting those huge enemies, so I think I would go Ranger, to be honest with you. Just having two really high damage shots would be perfect. Plat Stab. That's nice. Reactive targeting sensors. Ah. So I guess I would go Plat Stab then, if I weren't going defensive. I would go Ranger, Plat Stab, Shredder probably, because if I get two shots, the first one's going to do a lot of damage, and then the next one... or I can shred multiple targets if I wish. You can also build them tanky, I suppose. You could do automated threats. You could do reactive. No, I wouldn't do reactive targeting for tanky. I'd still do Plat Stab, honestly. I think Plat Stab, unless you're going Overwatch, is probably the best one to do. Then if you were doing tanky, I'd maybe do heat to keep yourself, like, at least kind of relevant. Because you'd be facing off against a lot of mechanizing units if you were tanking. So heat, damage control... repair servos, absorption fields. It's actually interesting how tanky the Valkyrie can get. All the mech classes now have the option to be tanky, but I would just park the Valkyrie right outside the range of like fire. They're not gonna be like super frontline mechs. They can be, but they don't have to be. And Danger was already a high damage dealer in the first place, so she's gonna get Ranger. She's going to get Plat Stab, she's going to get Shred, she's going to get Sharpshooter, maybe Damage Control, just give her a little bit of, tanking. Sharpshooter's great and all. Extra Crit's pretty good, too. And then you do Aggression, and then you do VPT. You can do VPT or Rapid Fire. I personally think VPT might be better, because if you're stacking with Ranger, you're going to just have a lot of damage. And then that reduced accuracy from Rapid Fire, well, you know, that's how that is. But you can shoot once, then rapid fire, but you'd be wasting a lot of ammo that way. I think VPT is just more solid, in my opinion. But I could be crazy. So I'm not sure what I want to do with her yet. I'll take suggestions too, or hey, from whoever Danger... Okay, you're big. You're a big person.
Contact detected.
Okay, hold up. I just realized I'm repairing my super heavy laser, but I don't know why. Repair bay. Yeah, I should cancel that, because there's literally no reason... Oh, I can't. Oh, you actually can't cancel repairs. Oh, I didn't know that. That's interesting. Why would you do that? I guess they're really cheap and you don't... Man, if I could get rid of anything in Long War, it would definitely be the repair system. Such a I mean, hey, I don't make this mod. I don't know about balance, but it's just so annoying. All right. I gotta think about this, though. He came over North America where I have nobody. Especially nobody good. Eagle. Oh, dear. Oh, dear, Eagle. Oh, dear goodness. The low raider over Mexico. Yeah, geez. All right. I guess I'll send a beaker first balance. Try to even out the score here. See what we can do. If anything at all. It's Mexico, though, right? So it's just probably going to get away after we shoot it a couple times. So that's disappointing to me. Oh, fuck off. Go ride a roller coaster. Okay, that's good. Keep on riding that roller coaster. Okay, we're not going to do that. We're going to try to keep the repairs below half health here. All right. Eagle, what are you thinking? You thinking you can handle this? If I put you on aggressive, do you think you can take this thing down before it takes you down? I don't know, Eagle. What are you thinking, Eagle? You need to get a kill, but do you need to get a kill today? Right now, at this very moment? You know what? In the spirit of scrubs, let's go, Eagle! That's gonna get away. Oh, no, it's not.
We're in pursuit.
But it might now, because I decided to go, Eagle!
Approaching target.
Oh, Eagle,
now.
You magnificent bastard. You just need to, yes, Eagle! Took no damage, good job, Eagle. Good job, Eagle. Eagle, my son. Okay, good. Great. Another crashed UFO. That went well last time. Except for Tettle Todd. I mean, not Tettle Todd. Anna Vasquez. But she's getting chopped up. It's alright. Nobody has to know. Alright. I made a decision. I have to scan ahead and wait for some people. You can tell by my voice cracking that I'm totally confident that we're not going to get a mission in the middle of this. To be honest, I'm pretty sure we are. Great. How much does it cost to build the things that I need for that? I would guess a lot. Alloy carbide plating, yep. Just a little bit more money than I have. That is good. Core armoring is especially good. Actually, I should probably buy some of that. Like, right now. Because if I have a mech with core armoring, at least I don't get critical hits. And I get a little extra hit points. So yes, I want to do that. Let's try to make one of those as soon as we can. I think I'm going to try to field danger on this mission, though. I am going to test her out. I hope that's not a decision I regret. Well, I regret it now. At least we have more people to maybe handle this scout. Scarecrow could probably take this thing out one swipe, but I think I want to save him. I should probably send in Cobalt first, and then Dancer to try and finish it. So that is what I will do. If we can reach it, that would be a travesty if we couldn't intercept it once. That would kill me. If it sends a fighter, though, Scarecrow's got it. Scarecrow's got everything. It feels like, it's hard to believe. Wow, that was like no damage. Okay. Alright, good. Good, we needed cash. What happened there? I've never seen them do that little damage before. I mean, I did up Interceptor's health just a smidge, so the critical hits wouldn't take them out in two shots. I have a mod for the air game that tweaks things just a teensy bit. It's like, not a lot. But I didn't notice that much of a difference. Huh. Alright, well that's interesting. Anyway, moving along. David Rice is back, but that's not who we're waiting for. Who we are waiting for... Oh no. Okay, we died there for a second, but we came back from the dead. I know not how, but we did. We're waiting for Ben Paddon, probably. And we are also waiting for Jack Watson in 2 hours, and LeBron Durant in 3 hours. Actually... I may have to go without an assault. I don't want to wait all 12 hours. That's a long time for this mission to wait, and then it's almost going to be gone. It's going to be 8 hours left, and then we might get another mission. I would feel probably just safe leaving it at this, so I'm going to try gearing up a squad and see what we can get away with. Okay, so I'm thinking we're trying something a little bit different today. Namely, well, we don't have any scouts or assaults. It's just completely stationary, I feel, except for maybe the odd... mobile unit with an arc thrower and grenades. I probably shouldn't actually even focus on captures at all, to be honest. But I always just hold out that tiny hope that we can maybe get one. I don't know. It's hard to say. I've only got one person with suppression this time, and that's Simons. And he's pretty stationary because of his gun and its bigness. Durant's here, though. My major plan here is to just blow things up with the grenades and also the rockets, which is also why I'm thinking I should not bring the arc thrower. So I can just blow everything up in my path and then have all these stationary crit soldiers, like Danger is probably going to be critting and blowing things apart. I actually did decide to go with the complete offensive perk list on her. So she's got Light 'em Up, Ranger, Plat Stab, Shredder. She's gonna be pretty crazy, and hopefully she'll get promoted from this too. If she survives, haha! She got a lot of health though, and I think she got a health for each rank up. She had started with 8, and then she went all the way up to 12, so that's really good. And I just need to get that core armoring on her, and she'll be pretty good, pretty decent. And then maybe some alloy carbide plating, and then a actually can't put both on, I can only do the scope and one other right now, because we're not at mech 3. But I digress. Core armoring is important for the tanky tanks, probably for everybody I'd put core armoring on, honest. You don't want your mechs to be critically hit, let me tell you what, because you're going to be weeping when that happens. It's going to be very bad. So hopefully, she's only got 8 defense. Man, that's nothing. What the hell, mech 1? That is like no defense at all. I'm going to have to have her in smoke all the time, which is good. We're bringing Kakukiwa, because she's got the smoke for that. And then Durant blowing things up. Simon's hollow shredding, yes. Oh, we're going to have a lot of shred on this mission. I love it. David Rice, he's going to be the crit infantry, sitting behind the lines, blowing things apart. I also give him the motion track for no reason, just because he can hold it. And, hey, infantry can still hold battle scanners. What a shock. Kelshmo at least has a bit more accuracy. I gave him the laser sight, so his unwieldy rifle will actually be kind of like... it's a laser rifle, but his second shot's going to suck. So that's why I'm doing that, not another battle scanner or motion tracker. I think with one motion tracker, 2 battle scanners, we should be okay, I hope. I mean, I'd really like to have more, to be honest, but it's really just tough. It is tough to do. I can maybe hawk him on the medic, get rid of a couple smoke grenades, but I really do need smoke. I really need smoke to happen, so, yeah, sorry. It's gonna be kind of a light. It's just gonna be like, we're gonna hold up, we're gonna bunker down, and we're gonna just try to destroy the enemy before they can destroy us. We'll hope they chance upon us. It's gonna be a really slow mission, so bear with me, but I hope you enjoyed this episode. And I hope you will enjoy future episodes to come. So lick this video, become a Brotherhood scribe. Wrong game. Not even the right game. And I hope to see you next time. And eventually, I hope to see you in XCOM 2. And hopefully not through the canon ending of this game. So, later.